हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शॉर्ट हैंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। दोस्तों, आप इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं डेली शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन के लिए। आज के मैट्रिक की ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के लिए आप डिस्क्रिप्शन की लिंक पर जा सकते हैं और इस तरह के और भी डिक्टेशन लिखने के लिए आप हमारे प्लेलिस्ट पर भी जा सकते हैं। शुरू करते हैं आज का डिक्टेशन, ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 233, वॉल्यूम नंबर 11 से, SSC स्टेनोग्राफर ग्रेड सी के लिए। बी रेडी, 10 सेकेंड्स, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। सर, व्हेन वन सीज द एस्टिमेट्स ऑफ द रेलवेज, वन फील्स दैट द एस्टिमेट्स आर टू मच इन रिगार्ड टू द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज कंपोनेंट। आई शुड कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट द रेलवे मिनिस्ट्री फॉर हैविंग स्पेंट लेस देन द एस्टिमेटेड अमाउंट्स, बट सर, एफिशियंसी डज नॉट मीन मोर एक्सपेंडिचर। यू मे स्पेंड लेस एंड स्टिल यू मे फील वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट इट। एफिशियंसी डज नॉट मीन ओनली अ मेजरमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी। डिलेज, इनएफिशियंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, लेट रनिंग ऑफ ट्रेन्स, लॉसेज, डिले इन मूविंग द पैसेंजर एंड गुड्स ट्रैफिक, ऑल दीज कंट्रीब्यूट टू अ सेटबैक टू नेशनल डेवलपमेंट एज वेल एज एफिशियंसी। सर, सो मच हैज़ बीन सेड अबाउट कोल एंड अबाउट द फेलुअर ऑफ द रेलवेज टू ट्रांसपोर्ट कोल। Coming from a place with the largest production of rice, I can say with great emphasis that in Andhra, for want of wagons, rice could not be transported to the south and to other places, especially Kerala. Not only rice, but with regard to articles like jaggery, charcoal, timber, firewood and other things, there was a heavy blockade in Andhra as far as the railways were concerned. Sir, while talking about coal, many honorable members referred to Bihar and West Bengal, but I would like to mention a word about the coal mines of the south. For want of wagons, about 7 lakh tons of coal continued to lie at the pithheads, and all this could not be moved to the south where there was a great demand for coal. The coal production in the collieries was according to the plan. It was not as if the railways did not expect or that the colliery produced something more than the expected allotment, but the railways feel short of it. In this connection, sir, I would like to point out that when there was an uproar in Parliament in February over the shortage of wagons on the Southeastern Railway, instead of trying to solve the problem in a more practical and in a good way, immediately the Railway Minister said that he had switched off 150 wagons serving the colliery belonging to the Central Railway to the Southeastern Railway. If you want to solve a problem, it is not by creating another problem. The Honorable Deputy Minister seems to be very doubtful, but I can tell him that 150 wagons were removed from the Central Railway. Yesterday, the minister, while answering one of the questions regarding the movement of coal, said that it was not always the railway's fault. I do agree that it is not always the railway's fault. The whole difficulty is that there is no coordination between his ministry and the other ministries. He also suggested that they would like to divert some of the coal and to road and waterways. I do welcome that suggestion. From today's papers, I find that the World Bank and Planning Commission and the Railway Ministry had a meeting with shipping companies who are willing to supply 24 more ships to transport 1 million-odd tons of coal to the south. In this connection, I would suggest that transport by water costs rupees 37 more per ton. Secondly, the coal supplied through ships is not graded properly in the sense that it gets mixed up. When they supply it to industries, the latter do not get the proper quality and what they get is not up to the mark. These things should be taken care of while diverting more and more coal towards the south through waterways. Sir, I have to say another thing. In the Nyogi committee, it was suggested that the railways should consider the question of their contribution to the general revenues. I do not say that the contribution from the railways to the general revenues is not good. It is quite welcome, but what I would suggest is that the railways can ill afford this much. Now that they have increased their dividend, they are not in a position to divert to that extent to the general revenues. If they have increased their dividend, it does not mean that the railways are prosperous. But what I feel is that the railways would do well to think twice about paying more because they have got any amount of work to be done in their own department. The dividend was increased on the understanding that there would be no change in the rates of freights. But the railways are not in a position to increase their freight rates because they have to face severe competition from other means of transport. Moreover, an increase in the contribution to the general revenues may affect national development. Therefore, I suggest that they should reconsider the decision about their contribution to the general revenues. Sir, the railways are a curious combination of a commercial concern and a public utility organ. On the one side, they have to spend more and more on the comforts of the nation and on the other, contribute more and more to the national development. Mr. Deputy Chairman, Sir, the bill before the House is for the abolition of 2-member constituencies and for setting up single-member constituencies. In other words, the President double-member constituencies are proposed to be bifurcated as single-member constituencies with reservation of seats or constituencies for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. Now, sir, a very crucial movement in the history of our young democracy has come. Where from has this reservation arisen? Is not reservation repugnant to the very principle of democracy? Still, we have reconciled ourselves to this reservation. A reservation might be in any form. It might be in the form of constituencies. It might be for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. It is a fact of history that in our society there are people who are called weaker sections and they go by the name of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. I do not know whose fault it is, but anyway in our society. So thanks for watching. Do like, subscribe and share.